Hey everyone, in today's video, I'm going to show you how to work with transitions in CapCut Pro. So this is going to be on a Mac. It's similar to a PC. It's almost identical. So the first thing you want to do is you want to come over and you want to import your videos. You can see I've got two videos over here and I've got my transition here. So let's say I'm just going to delete this bottom layer here. I'm just going to come over here, or what I can do is scroll here, highlight all of it and press the delete button. And now I'm just working with this person. And what I want to do is, let's say this person moves over to the left a little bit. What I want to do is create a split. I could press B, or when I click on the video in the area, I could just click over here. And now I've got a separation between that one video into two. So as you can see, and now I can just move it over and it auto links. If you want it to auto link, you just want to make sure that this is selected. So you could turn off auto linkage and basically it'll link automatically. See that as it connects. And now what you want to do to add your transition, you want to come over here to transitions. And there's two ways on how I like to find my transitions. It's either by one that's trending, because sometimes you'll see at the top right now it's trending. These are trending transitions, as well as if you've used transitions before, you could also favorite. So one of my favorite transitions is this color glitch. So if you see a transition that you want to use and you like it, you can just come over here to the bottom and just press the star button and it will highlight it. You could see it as it turned yellow. So now what I want to do is I want to go to one of my favorites and I could do use this rotating glitch. So all I'm going to do is just, I left click on it once and you can see what it's going to do when I click on it. I'm going to come over here and I'm just going to put it in between these two. And you can see that as it auto fills it. And then when you're on your timeline, just take your mouse, hover over here, and now you can just kind of scroll and just see how it looks. And that is your transition. Now, if you wanted to see how it works real time, just come over to the left. And what I like to do is press the space bar and it auto plays, and then bring it back, press the space bar, see if you like it. If you don't like it, you could always just highlight this transition itself. See how I clicked off and I clicked on, it highlights it. I press delete. And now what I want to do is I want to look for another transition. Now this is called the black fade, and this is very popular. The black fade is really popular. So now you can see how it transitions from one scene or one video to the next piece. So you can see it. And what you could also do is you could actually extend the fade if you'd like, or you can shorten it if you want it shorter. So you can see the duration over here is between 0.1 to 0.5 of a second. You can see it right there. So that's how you work with transitions in CapCut Pro. If you like the video, don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, and I'll see you in the next one.